The floor is given to Mr. Taleb Rifai, the Secretary General of the World Tourism Organization.
Mr. President, what a pleasure and an honor to be with you again. Every time I'm here in Baku, every time I have the honor and the opportunity of meeting you, I'm renewed with hope and optimism. Listening to you this morning has reinforced that in our minds. Your presence here carries a great, great message. We understand it, we respect it, and we value it. Thank you for being with us. Thank you. President Boubacar Keïta, you come from a great country, and you're here to give the support to a wonderful cause. We thank you for joining us. Madam Vice President, it's an honor and a pleasure to finally meet with you and be here. Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you for all your good efforts. Ladies and gentlemen, I wish I could recognize you all one by one. I see in this room many, many good friends, many wonderful people that have contributed so much to making this world a better place. But you can understand the limitation of time. So thank you so much for being here. My dear friends, it's a pleasure and an honor to be with you today in this beautiful Baku morning. Baku is a wonderful city. While flying last night, only 3 hours ago, over the city of Baku, I was always reminded how every time I'm here, I'm overwhelmed and surprised with how much has happened in this city. Every time I come, there's a new scene. I was here only 1 year ago, and still, I was overwhelmed to wake up this morning from the balcony of my room in the hotel to see the new fresh energy of Baku. My dear friends, Mr. President, Albert Einstein once said, "The distinction between the past, present and future is only a stubbornly persistent illusion. For though we acknowledge the past, we cannot change it. And though we cannot predict the future, we can manage, help shape the future we want." Let's always keep that in mind. As global leaders, we are entrusted with the task and will continue to be and to try to steer the ship the best possible way into what is becoming a rather unknown future and navigate through uncertain times and difficult times. Because indeed, we're living times of confusion and uncertainty. Another great thinker and writer, Charles Dickens, once said, "We live in the worst of times, we live in the best of times. We live in times of natural disasters and health pandemics, times of economic crisis, times of terror threats and wars, times of increasing assaults on human rights, times of persistent inequality, times of menace of the climate change, but also times of isolationism, travel bans and building walls. But despite these complex and interlinked challenges, despite the acts against freedom of movement and travel, a sector that I very proudly represent, I want to challenge all of this and suggest that we are indeed living in the best of times. We're living in a beautiful world, my dear friends. As a global community, we're indeed living a better world from the world we came from. I come from a generation that still remembers that, and I'm sure many of you here in this room would share this feeling. We're today more connected, more informed, more involved. We therefore know more and care more about each other. We're more compassionate and more understanding. When an earthquake happens in Japan, or a tsunami happens in Japan, it happens in my backyard. When girls are kidnapped in Nigeria, they're my girls, they're your girls. We know more, we care more, we indeed live in a better world. And it's in this new world that I would like to believe, as a representative of a sector within the UN system that is entrusted with travel and tourism, that the transformative power of travel is a cornerstone in this new world. Because, Mr. President and my dear friends, only last year there was 1,235 million international tourists that crossed borders in one single year. That is almost one out of six of the people of the world making an international trip every year. In doing so, we have tremendous benefits to communities, economies, and societies. One out of 10 of the jobs of the world are generated by this human activity called travel, 10% of world GDP. We have become the third largest industry in the world after chemicals and fuels. By the year 2030, the travelers of the world will be crossing borders in one single year at the number of 1.8 billion international travelers. I'm therefore very sure that in 40, 50, 60 years from now, the future generations would look back at this time and say, that was the age of travel. But with growth comes power. With power comes responsibility. We can end up with 1.8 billion opportunities or 1.8 billion disasters. It's all up to us. What we need to do is we need to make this 1.8 billion travelers opportunities for inclusive economic growth, opportunities for better jobs, decent jobs, opportunities to protect our natural and cultural heritage, opportunities to better know and respect each other, and in the process, build a better world. Our Secretary General Antonio Guterres was quoted many times by many of the speakers before, and I would like to quote him on something connected to us, because he said, and I quote, "Beyond the measurable advantages of travel and what it can make possible, it is a bridge to better mutual understanding among people from all walks of life," unquote. Travel, Mr. President, my dear friends, open minds, open eyes, and open hearts. We become better people when we travel. I travel the world. I am a better person. Each one of you becomes a better person when they travel. My dear friends, the world may be suffering from so many deficits: educational deficit, economic deficit, technological deficit. But the one most critical and most important deficit of them all is the deficit of tolerance and understanding. And there is nothing more powerful than people meeting each other, rubbing shoulders, to break down stereotypes and fight bigotry and build bridges of understanding and compassion. Building a better world does not mean building walls or banning people from traveling. I know that I'm touching on very sensitive issues, but not only because this increases tension and therefore increases security risks itself as a result, but also because ultimately we're bending and serving the agenda of these forces of darkness. They want us to stop traveling. They want us to be separate from each other by mistrust, hate each other. This is their agenda, not our agenda. Building a better world, however, means cooperating and addressing global challenges without compromising people's rights to move around and exercise their very basic human right. Travel today, my friends, have become a human right. My right to relax, my right to enjoy the world, my right to see other people, my right to educate yourself, myself, my right to do business. This is our agenda. Mr. President, in the year 2015, the United Nations General Assembly accomplished three very important milestones. One, it approved the 17 Sustainable Development Goals. 193 member states, governments, approved the roadmap for 2030. But two, in December of 2015, we all signed the Paris Agreement, which was a very important milestone. And three, I'd like to also share with you that in September of 2015, this year, 2017, was declared and designated as the International Year of Sustainable Tourism for Development and Peace. 2017, therefore, is a very special year for us and a unique opportunity for all of us to come together to promote the contribution that we can do to the better world. And as a grand 21st century human activity, to a better future for people and planet. Today in our globalized world, interconnected world, strengthening global partnership is very crucial. Global challenges can only be addressed through global partnership. There is no other way. Platforms such as the World Forum for Intercultural Dialogue, the one we're in today, are ideal opportunities to strengthen partnerships and commitments. My dear friends, one last thought, as this definitely may be my last official visit here to your beautiful country, Mr. President, as Secretary General of UNWTO. We travel to places that we respect. Respect the people, respect the society, respect the culture, respect the nature. Because in doing so, we gain our self-respect. We don't go to places that we don't feel good. That is why, Mr. President, people will continue to travel and to come to Azerbaijan. Azerbaijan, a land that has so much respect in the eyes of so many people. You call it the land of fire. Fire embodies energy. And you could see it all over the room. You could see it all over this place. You have led a wonderful nation. You're a lucky president, Mr. President, presiding over wonderful people. My dear friends, let's always remember that whatever our business in life is, whatever our business in life is, and I'm sure you're all leading very important businesses and careers in life, let's always remember that our core business in life is simply to make this world a better place. Thank you very much. Teşekkürler.